The desperate race to save the crew of the ARA San Juan is the largest search and rescue operation that Argentina has attempted in 30 years. An Argentine Navy spokesman said that seven countries have lent aircraft and ships to the massive effort to locate the missing 44 sailors aboard the sub. The San Juan was heading from the southern tip of Argentina to port in Mar del Plata when it vanished last Sunday. Argentine naval officials say the crew reported a short circuit to the submarine's battery shortly before the ship was lost.
The vessel came to the surface and he communicated the failure. This is why the submarine command asked them to change course.
Despite days of searching in rough seas, the sub has still not been found. Among the missing is Eliana Krausik, who made history as Argentina's first female submarine officer. Searchers are now concentrating their efforts on a 35-square-mile area, 330 miles off the Argentine coast. The United States has sent submersible vehicles that could aid in the rescue if the San Juan didn't sink in waters too deep to be reached.
A lot of this depends on the depth of water. If the submarine is on the bottom, we don't know that. So it's going to depend on where it is and how deep it is, because there are real limits about our ability to rescue people out of submarines at certain depths.
If their sub did sink, the crew of the San Juan could have gone down with just 7 days' worth of air, giving rescuers precious little time to reach them before it will be too late. Patrick Ottman, CNN Havana.